Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Footlight Theater at the world-famous Parliament House. For those of you who've never been here before and you were a little concerned about where you were coming, well, just relax. The moment you step foot out of your cars, your reputations were shot to hell. So you might just as well enjoy yourselves. And without further ado, ladies and gentlemen,
say some things, and I'm going to not say some things on the grounds that might incriminate me. But it went from a very treacherous situation to hallelujah days and everything in between. I can remember one time when I referred to the time when we were smoking pot in the dressing room. And this is way before Don and Susan came, way back in the 1990 something. It was New Year's Eve, and just her and I, we used to have an event in here. And she said, well, Darcel, Happy New Year's. And I said, well, Happy New Year's to you. And I was putting on my little dress, getting ready to go out and mingle. She said, well, I have a little celebration stuff right here. I go, what celebration? She pulled out this fat joint. And here we were, standing on the chair. The vent, a fan was blowing the air outside. And we were smoking, just smoking marijuana. And someone went, oh my God. She swallowed the joint. I ran out the room, and of course it was somebody who probably would have came in and said, can I have a hit? But a good thing went to waste, and we laughed about that for the long.
Or here Pussy, you know, Chuckles would come up with something that was just, everybody would scream.
You want some pussy? Let's see what Pussy has to say on the 4th of July. Give me a one. Give me a two. Give me, I think Miss Pussy should sit on a flag 3.
the last couple of years she was working, she was wearing one eyebrow, and I was like, come on, Paul, let me draw that other eyebrow for you. And he refused to wear that other eyebrow. He was totally different from everybody else.
But my favorite thing that I will always, always remember is the dress with no back. Always. What are you doing? What are you doing?
This is the stopper for the hole. The hole in the stage floor, not my hole. My stopper is a great deal larger than this, believe me. And I hardly ever put it in anyway, so what the fuck? I like to keep my hole open. You never know what's gonna go by that you might want to have slip in for an hour or two.
What's your name? Debbie, and where do you topless dance? You ain't getting one of these boys. You're homosexuals. And you should be a lesbian.
Are you a lesbian?
No!
You're not a lesbian? But you see, we don't have any prejudices, so you can stay here. We would prefer that you try to think about licking a pussy while you're watching the show.
First virtual, huh?
It's so nice to see so many of you here. I love the interim. That's called the intermission I love the time between the time. Because I sit at the bar and people buy me drinks. It's a sipping drink, but we don't really have time for that.
Liquor to the right of me, liquor to the left of me.
One thing I learned a lot from her, she was the one who basically started me on my journey, taught me all about the theater, and taught me all about Broadway, about being grand, about holding back, the crescendo.
My words fit that tune. Right now they're listening to me. My lyric reads like a poem. It surely stands on its own. It makes me proud to hear that music. It's the total expression of me. To be more specific, this place is terrific. As long as they're playing my song. Who would have known that 2 years ago when Leon asked, can't love and be fun? You know it made the top ten. All good things come to an end. I wish they'd play it again and again. Let it keep on playing. Oh God, I'm praying.
I would just take any Broadway song, as this is what she taught me, not to rely on MTV, but to rely on your own interpretation of the song. You can take elements from something, but you need to craft it in your own way. And she would do that with a lot of Broadway tunes that nobody never heard of. Often she would get the original Broadway recording before it came out, and you would hear that song and you would see it on Broadway or see it in a theater, and you go, oh no, they're not doing it right, because P would craft it in her own special way. And one of the songs that that reminds me of her most is The Kiss of the Spider Woman.
Go for my crotch and try and grab it.
Did he succeed?
Yeah, and then he wouldn't let go.
You come with me, dear. You need a drink. Go back with her. Go back with her. Yes. You've learned how to put up with the smell. Stay with it. You're a little backwards, aren't you, Queen?
So I understand you're a heterosexual.
Yep.
A confirmed heterosexual?
Yep.
Well, you can say that now, but you haven't left yet.
Come on up here, Chris. And he was coming in with his girlfriend. What's her name again? Andrea. How fast I forgot. Andrea.
Are you married?
Yeah.
Is your wife with you?
No.
Good.
Come here with me. We're going to take you in the dressing room. And we're going to teach you. We're just going to put you in drag. Yo, come on. You've got lovely hair. We'll roll it and we'll put it. We live in America, ladies and gentlemen, but we are a minority. We are a minority that is in a constant struggle to achieve the equality that everyone else is guaranteed in this country. And I think that the minute that we decide not to look at each other as sex, S-E-C-T-S, or groups, that we are all human and that we are all part of the human heart, we'll be that much better off.
I would have to say the day that I brought in the costume for him to try on for the Weir at Theater Downtown. He just said to me, darling, I love you very much, but I'm not wearing any of that. This is what I'm going to wear.
Paul was going to do what Paul wanted to do. If Paul went on time, Paul went on time. If Paul wanted to take long, Paul took long.
Never argue with Paul or Miss P because you will lose.
In a battle of wits with P, the whole rest of the world was totally unarmed.
It was his show. It was Paul's house, not my house.
Miss P. Exuberant, gaudy,
outrageous, chancy, gutsy,
scary.
He scared the shit out of me.
Fabulous, fierce, freaky, flawless, and fun.
Just, I think just talented.
Sister, bitch, fun.
Drag couture.
Her attitude, fuck you.